From the end of the top section on page Sadik Zayin. In the parentheses, just the emphasis of what we are been learning. It's a phenomenal thing. There is the Chochmah. Chochmah is the beginning of awareness, of knowledge, of sichlit. Beginning of all this knowledge comes from the godly presentation, the godly presence. That is the beginning of all. That is what makes there be anything. And this true first being presents itself to the human soul in the form of Chochmah. Thus, Chochmah actually connects and fully relates, as a matter of fact, in terms of the way this mimer here, rather in contrast to the ways it's discussed elsewhere, Chochmah and this is one and the same thing. There is not even a transition from yesh ha-emiti into Chochmah. Yesh ha-emiti rests in Chochmah, is present in Chochmah. This Chochmah, and this yesh ha-emiti, that's in the Chochmah, this is what gives the neshama the full awareness, the full confidence, and the full relationship to reality itself. Yesh ha-emiti is contained in the Chochmah. In Chochmah there is not a question, is this all real? Not because it's got an answer to this question, but because the question doesn't exist. It is into the reality, this Chochmah. This kind of reality, of basic reality, is necessary is imperative at all levels of awareness. But clearly, at the further developmental levels, it is reduced in its fullest impact. Like we say all the time, yes, indeed, there is the concept of a table in the human soul, but when this table is actualized and becomes a physical presence in the world, it has to be built in a certain way. It will not be built by you wanting it, although that wanting it is the soul of that table. But then it has to be actualized and translated in worldly terms, in so to speak, in its components. But even as it is translated in components and becomes really a physical worldly presence, there has to be the sense of that reality in it. That reality reaches the lowest levels of worldly definition via what's called hanacha sichlit, which means it's a seichel, which can explain itself, but the seichel itself is like a hanacha. Hanacha means it's an accepted seichel. A recognized seichel. It is not a seichel that is being debated and is being proven. Like we're saying all the time, a human being does not recognize that he is different than an animal because he has proven it to himself. How then? He has it inherently in his seichel. This is the nekuda, this is the chochmah of that seichel. The chochmah, this is the godly element of everything that gives it a sense of reality. At this lower level, it's called hanacha sichlit. What's the difference? In its impact, it's the same thing, but it's on a lower level, which permits you to relate to a table of four legs and a board instead of just the truth of a table. Now, you go through a seichel, and the seichel tells you how to build a table. But what is in the kudu? What is it about? That which is presented from in the hanacha sichlit, which is reflective of the chochma. A human being does not eat at a table because it's more convenient, because it's neater, more respectful. But because this is how a human being eats. He doesn't stoop down to the ground. It's brought to him. And he does not eat by putting his face into plate, like all animals do. he lifts the food up to his mouth and feeds his mouth. This is not out of convenience, but this is out of the definition of a human being. This is what's called hanacha sichlit, which is on par in a certain sense with Chochmah, but lower than Chochmah, because it has a sichli. It has also an explanation along with it. But here is the important but. Why is it so important that a human being should be a human being? This is what's happening in our world. I want to be an animal. But you can find me to act like a human being. Why? To that, the answer is, the only answer is, that there's a creator in the world. And if you want to change yourself from what he made you, it's disaster only, and it is the most terrible error, mistake. It's rebellion against your creator. Stupid is a title, is a compliment. And this error. This is called Anoche Sichlis. Anoche Sichlis is, this is the truth of the neshama coming down to a conscious and a practical level. But it remains Anoche. It's not questioned. It's not explaining itself. And anybody who needs an explanation is mistaken. Who seeks an explanation is mistaken. Because it does not really need an explanation. Okay, two lines from the end, in the parentheses. Anoche Sichlis, the Rebbe said, that gives support, empowers the Hasoga. The Hasoga means the comprehension and the Seichel. As we discussed yesterday, the Be'emes, in parentheses, the Be'emes for in that truth, B'chol Haskola Chadosho. In every new Haskola, in every new comprehension, every new realization, K'mei Shehi Bin Kudas Haskola, as this new realization is found and is drawn from the Nekudas Haskola, from the initial point, what is this about? Yikro Bichinas Hanoch. In principle, this is the Hanoch. Not the Seichel, the explanation, the reasoning, but the Hanoch. It's in the Shomed conclusion, it's in the Shomed decision. It's a human decision. In principle, it's Hanoch. Vehi Davka. And specifically and exclusively, it, this Hanocha, not the Sichli, but the Hanocha, Sibas HaSichli VaHasog. That is the cause for the Sichli, for the explainable elements, and Hasog on the comprehension. Every Seichel is at its core Hanocha. Rak accept. So Bembison is in every sikh. Accept. Sheniken hadover b'yoseid, that it is more obvious, more recognizable, and it is recognized excessively. This principle that it is hanacha sichlis is excessively and is recognized beize eimek upinimis haseichel, in some depth of seichel. A seichel that can be demonstrated, although this it also is at its core hanacha sichlis, but it is not as obvious and as expressed as it is in eimek upinimis haseichel. As it is in a depth of seichel, in a deep seichel that can hardly be expressed. This is where the hanacha sichlis is much more recognizable. In other words, to summarize in one word, in one statement, what we are learning about the seichel of a human being. The seichel of a human being at its core, what makes it seichel is the chochmah element. The human spark, which cannot be questioned. Which was granted by its creator. Zehu, thus this, the aforementioned, traveled, explains the principle she'achochmo nikras kodesh. Chochmo is called kodesh. Ukmei shekosu, as the posik says, Ushmartem as Hashabos, you should guard the Shabbos, ki kodesh hi, because Shabbos is kodesh. Ve'odua, and it is known, the Shabbos hu gilui meichin di abo. That Shabbos, the uniqueness of Shabbos, is that meichin di abo, meichin abo means chochmah. That moichin of chochmah is revealed on Shabbos. Shabbos, in other words, is essentially, although Shabbos is a day of the week, but it is the supreme element of days. It's the chochmah element of days. Moichin di abo. Vise b'zehar. And the Zohar comments on this and says, Kodesh himila begarmei. Kodesh himila is a word, mila means a word, begarmei unto itself. Meaning to say, it is not an adjective describing something. It is a standalone word. It is holiness, not holy. Holy has to have an object. Holiness is the truth of holiness itself. Kodesh is a word, in Russian Kodesh, you know, the conjugation of Russian Kodesh is phenomenal. There's Kodesh and there's Kodosh. If you put the Vav under the after the Dalet, it's the same meaning basically, but it's a different word completely. Kodosh means an adjective. It is holy. Kodesh is holiness.
Mila begarmei is to say it's a noun. It's unto itself.
Right, the word unto itself. Shabbos is called kodesh, not kodesh. It's a holy day. It's holiness. The Pirush Kodesh. And what is the meaning of the word Kodesh? The word Kodesh, what is Kodesh itself denote? Hu heyoisei muvdo. It is pointing to the fact, and it's describing the union that is muvdo, that is separate. Separate is separate from everything else. It does not mix in with anything else. That's made Kodesh. Okmoi, as in the Inyan, as in the example, Sheinyan ha-havdolo, that what is the principle of havdolo, of separation? Who? The principle of Adola is Shein Misarevim Dugmosei. Abdullah means Shein Misarevim Dugmosei, that it does not mix with something similar to itself. Dugmosei, something akin to itself. And doesn't mix with it. That's Abdullah. Like the Jewish people were separated from all other peoples. Va'avdil eskem al ha'amim, I separated from the nation. This separation, you don't have to separate a human being from an animal. That's not a separation. But separation, when you separate one human being from another human being, and you say, these two don't mix, even though By there's a great similarity between them. That's Havdolah, that's Kodesh. Havdolah, the principle of Havdolah is saying Misavi Dugmosi, he doesn't mix with Dugmosi. Dugmosi means that which is similar to himself. Hainu, I said that already, let me say it again. On the third line at the end, Hainu, which means the gam in dovah sheniva sheikin yeitzibei, even a such thing that appears to be similar to itself, with doim aloi, and similar to itself, even there it is not mixed. Doesn't have dovah. You separate. Havdolah means an act of separation. The havdolo midova sheine biyerkoi, because separating from something sheine biyerko, that is not in its proximity, there is no similarity. Ein ze havdolo, that is not havdolo, that is not a separation. The concept of separation doesn't apply to you. Of course they're separate, but they're separate not because you're separating them, but because they're different creatures. Even as it is not applicable to say that the human being is separated from the animal. Why is it not possible to say? Because it's not in that proximity. There is not anything that correlates them, that needs to be actively separated. Kim only kasher moved on midobo shebiyarech elov, when one is separated from something that is in proximity to itself. And as for example, when we say al hachochom, referring to a chochem, shehu chochem godol, that he is a very great chochem, behaflo behavdol, his chochmah is of such caliber that it is behaflo, it is Flow means wondrous, v'havdola, and separating from other chachomim. Which means he is separate gam ha-chachomim. He is separate even from chachomim. Delgabe anoshim pshutim, because relative to simple people, ein shayach lema shehu muvdo. There, to say that he is separate is not applicable. Shaharei, since that ein meyerecho mimuhusoi klal, they are not in proximity to him. And they're not mimhus klal, they're not of his reality at all. Mimhus ha-seichel, in the seichel realm. Therefore, they don't mix. You don't have to apply any kind of separation effort. Only when you talk about other chachomim, shehei mikol mokoim biarkoi, which are nonetheless, even though that he is a supreme chachom, still, however, they are meyarkoi, then his proximity. You talk about similar entities, but one is greater than the other. Shayach loimer, this is where it's applicable, as far as to say, shehu muvdol, that he is nonetheless separated. So this separation is a separate step identifying him. The davko al dovor sheyesh as a dimyu, because only on something that has any kind of similarity, any kind of
comparison.
Any kind of means of comparison, noy for loshen havdola. Only there the word havdola is applicable. Because Havdolah means to say, Shim heyoisei doime elov, that even though he is similar to him, he is like him, mekomokoim, yet still einem misarev imoy. He does not mix with him. This is the meaning of Havdolah. V'chein b'chinas havdola de chochmo. This is, an explanation of the born havdola. And now applying it to chochmo, this is how it is by chochmo. Havdola de chochmo hu shehi muvdelas. It is that chochmo is separated. Miliyas misu musuk b'seichel. It's separate from being able to be comprehended in seichel. Chochmah. The word Havdolah applies to Chochmah. And we shall see, because in Chochmah there is something which is similar to Seich. So by Chochmah there is a proper term to say that it's moved all, that it, because it doesn't mix, it doesn't mix with what? Okay, he said like this. Chochmah shehi muvdeles min is musuk b'seichel. The Havdolah of Chochmah is that it is separated from being able to be musuk, to be comprehended in seichel. Ve'ein zeh bebechines riyeh de Chochmah. This separation aspect, as applied to Chochmah, is not appropriate to apply it to the Riyiyo aspect of Chochmah. Why? Shein zeh bebechinas sichli, because Riyiyo is not in a sichli realm, ve'ein be'erech hasogo, and it is totally not of outer proximity of hasogo comprehension. So that the word separation is incorrect, is not applicable, because there is no similarity between that and bina, so that you have to separate them. So in Chochmah there is the re'iyah aspect, re'iyah de Chochmah, that you see, you take things because of direct recognition of that sight. That aspect of Chochmah does not need to be separated from Seichel, because there's nothing that will mix them.
Uh-huh. Somehow, Seichel relates, like we have the mind's eye, but...
One second. So this is not in the Riyad Chochmah. Why? Because Shayza Bechin is sichli. Because this Riyad is not in the sichli Bechin, in sichli realm. Veina Bera Hasogo, it's certainly not in proximity to Hasogo, the company being comprehended. Kihim. Where then does the term Havdolo apply to Chochmah? Only Bechin is Hasichli de Chochmah. In the sichli aspect of Chochmah, as we've been discussing the whole time, that in the Nekudas HaSkola, there is the Nekuda, the Hanocha, and there is the sichli. That aspect of Chochmah, that in Chochmah itself, it makes sense, so to speak. It's a sichli. In the sichli element, this is where the one half dollar becomes Jermaine. Why there? On there, the word Havdol is appropriate. The Meyoi say Doime Lahasoga de Bino. For despite the fact that it's similar to the Hasoga of Bino, because this is the Sichli of Chochmah. But in truth, it is in Havdolah manner from the Hasogah de Bina. The Sichli of Chochmah. The way we refer to the Sichli of Chochmah is, even though we'll take it down from Chochmah, take it down to plain sight, because plain sight is an appropriate demonstration of the Inyan Chochmah as a mushroom. We see things because they're there to be seen, because they're real, but still, in that experience of sight, as soon as we see it, we see along with seeing it the reason why it's there. It makes sense that it's there. The thing that makes sense, this is the sichli within the Chokh, within the Riyah. This sichli part, this is a sichli part of the Riyi, of the Chochmah. In this sichli is similar to the sichli of Bina, although it's much superior, because the sichli comes along with the Riyi. This is why you hear that this is a sichli that's muvdol, that stands apart from the sichli of the Bina. Let's look inside now. Kihim bebchinas hasichlit de Chochmah. Okay, this is the sixth line from the bottom. Hasichlit de Chochmah. The sichli of Chochmah. This sichli of Chochmah goes along with the Chochmah, with the Re'i of Chochmah. As we said, even in the physical sight, there is the union that that what I see makes sense. It's accepted by me not only because I see it, but because it makes sense. This is the sichli part that comes along with the ear. This sichli part needs to be separated. Needs to be emphasized that it's a different level. For although it is similar to the hasog of bino, pardon me, of the comprehension of bino, in truth, however, is in truth it is in Habdola manner. It is separate. It's a different kind of hasoga than bina. Hasoga bina. Although it is in the realm of hasoga, it's comprehended. This is where Havdolo applies. That even though it is it has similarity to the Hasoga de Bino, but this Hasoga is in Havdola manner. In truth, it is in Havdola, it is in a separate world, in a separate level for Hasoga de Bino. Mipnei, let me just finish this. Mipnei, because She'etzem inyan hasichli de chochma. Because the whole phenomenon of sichli of chokhmah, mitzad atzma means from its inception, not because of what you identify with. In essence, the sichli, where does the sichli come from? The sichli of chokhmah, where does it come from? Hulamar ma'asoga b'emes. It is v'etzem, in essence, above hasoga. Kiyim, what then is the means by which one knows and relates it to the sichli of chokhmah? It is bebchinas hanocho. It is known and accepted bebchinas hanocho in a hanocha manner. The sichli is known in a hanocha manner rather than in the comprehension manner. This is why we say that this is separate, in a separate category. It's a different kind of sichli. It's sichli, but it's sichli of chokhmah. Like we said before. What you see, and then there is the aspect that it makes sense. Compare the citing it to the making sense of it. Making sense is so to speak, relative to seeing. It is a much lower level of conviction. Reality. This is the sichli within the experience of Riyah. But this sichli is much superior to the sichli of comprehension of being. Because the sichli comes directly from the sight. The Riyah itself is kind of presenting to you the sichli, telling you that this is something which is right and which makes sense.
What is going on there? the heat.
This is why this is called Havdalah. It's a sichli, but it's a sichli that comes from Chochmah rather than from Binah. And the proper way to define it and to relate and to explain it is what's called hanacha. Yes, it makes sense, but it makes sense because it makes sense to my seichel, not because I've proven it. Because I went through a process of proving it.
Isn't that the definition of seichel?
What?
Not what I land up deducing or proving, but what came via chokmah.
This is the source of chokmah. Yeah, this is the higher element of seichel. This is what we're trying to say. The basis of chokmah of seichel is hanacha sichlis.
Right. There is no other basis. That's how we started out saying.
Well, yes. Now there is no other basis because we have come to understand it. But initially we say hasogo, approving it, and all the arguments are going into proving it. This is what the seichel is. Prior to having this, learned it, somebody asked me what is a table is. A table is a board and four legs. And why does it stand there? Because it stands, because it's made to stand.
As opposed to?
As opposed to the chokhmah behind it. What? The chokhmah. Yes, it's present there because of that.